Hello, I'm Bryant Lin, and welcome to our seventh virtual Stanford Medicine Stuck at Home concert brought to you by Medicine and the Muse. I'm really happy to bring to you this concert for the seventh time. I'm just amazed that we were able to do this. Sorry, I have to change the spotlight here. You'd think I'd get good at this after doing this seven times, but never getting good. You can't teach an old dog new tricks. But today we have a fantastic lineup. This is a special concert as always. We are in honor of Nurses Week as well as Mother's Day this Sunday. So we will ask our performers to share a little bit about some thoughts about nurses and about Mother's Day. But I'd love to turn it over to Jackie Genovese, who without this, none of this would happen. And who has been really working hard on arranging the performers and the program for every concert. So please, Jackie.
Thanks, Bryant. And again, want to thank everybody who's participated and also the Department of Medicine and Medicine and the Muse for making this really possible, especially during this time. Another thing that we noticed about today, it's the seventh concert on May 7th. So Brian joked it's our 007 concert. So also if you have a favorite Bond movie or a favorite actor who played Bond, you can let us know about
Sean
that.
Sean Connery all the way.
I agree. Sean Connery and then Daniel Craig as second. But I hope you enjoy the concert. And without further ado, I want to introduce our first performers, the Costanza Fong Family String Trio. And as soon as Brian switches, I am going to allow Chris to say the name of what they're playing because I don't want to mess it up. If you want to say the name of what you're playing, and then I was just going to mention the St. Lawrence String Quartet and our poetry and music event that we typically do with you in the fall.
Sure. You want to do that afterward or first?
If you say the name of the piece.
Okay.
And then I'll say something about that, and then we can do the Mother's Day, James Bond, Nurses Week question.
Okay, you got it. Okay, so piece first. Yeah. Okay, this is a bit unusual for a string trio, this specific piece. It is the Pie Jesu movement from the Requiem, Opus 9, by Maurice Durufle, French composer. He composed this piece in 1947. And I got really excited about the piece when Deborah and I, this is Deborah here, by the way, my wife, and our daughter, Isabella, can you see my, yeah, she's over here. Okay, we're our family string trio. And we got really excited when Deborah and I were part of a performance and recording project at Memorial Church with my colleagues, Stephen Sano, and the Stanford Chamber Chorale, as well as Robert Hugh Morgan playing organ, and some other guests as well, and the rest of my quartet. We were all involved with this project. Did the performances, made a recording. Recording's about to be released on May 15th of the Durufle Requiem. So I got so excited about this particular piece because in the original version, it's for organ, a low female voice, low alto voice, and cello solo. And I thought, wouldn't this make a nice string trio? So I went ahead and arranged it for trio. And this is the world premiere of my string trio arrangement of the Pie Jesu from the Durufle Requiem.
Oh, that's fantastic. That's so exciting. Thank you for sharing that with us. Yeah. And so I just wanted to mention, Chris is part of the St. Lawrence String Quartet at Stanford, and we typically co-host an event, Music and Poetry, where the String Quartet picks a piece of music and plays it, and our physicians write poems based on the music. And we will do it in the fall, whether virtually or in person.
One way or another.
Yeah, one way or another.
Always great, great fun for us. We enjoy it a lot. Thank you.
Great. And so, Nurses Week, Mother's Day, James Bond, any of the above you would like to comment on?
Yes, well, the Durufle Requiem appears in a lot of James Bond movies. Just kidding.
That would be awesome.
Well, this, I mean, of course, to be thankful for nurses, my wife Deborah's mother was a nurse. And she comes from a family of medical folks, actually. Her father's an orthopedic surgeon, brother is a neurologist. My family, not medical folks, but we certainly love medical people from the medical community, and we're so grateful for all that you have done in the medical community, well, always, but especially during this time of great crisis. And a shout out to moms. As I understand it, my mom is listening now. So hi, Mom. Happy Mother's Day. And another mom over here, and my sisters and friends who are mothers, I wish you all the very, very best of Mother's Days, even though it will be essentially in isolation, but still, doesn't mean we can't have a good time and celebrate.
Right. Great. Thank you.
You're welcome.
I just want to remind the audience to put your comments in the Q&A, any applause, emojis, please put them in the Q&A, and Jackie is moderating our Q&A when we will, of course, as usual, read a few select comments after each performance. Thank you.
Okay.
Incredible. We actually also have a question for you, and I'm not qualified to answer this at all. From Jeremy Joseph, what should the audience focus on when listening to orchestral music?
A cello, basically.
For example,
Go ahead.
For example, the entire combination of sounds together or the individual contributions?
It's an excellent question, and it's kind of both. Yeah, I think it just depends on the particular part of the music one is focusing on, but there are elements of both. I mean, great orchestral music it excels because of both of those things, because of the ability of the sounds to come together and create this blend, and also for the ability of pieces to bring out individual sounds. And it just kind of depends on the piece. So it's a really good question, I think, and there's no clear answer to it. Mm.
And I'm going to read some comments. I think, you know, one thing I've noticed that, you know, we ask people to put these comments in, and of course they're busy listening. So there's always a little delayed reaction there as we get the comments rolling in. From Audrey, so lovely and played with love. Thank you. From Kate James, very nice. From David Anderson, beautiful. From Nassim, I'm going to pass on the name. I don't want to butcher it. Lovely. From Prince Alexander, very well done. From Robert Morgan, bravi tutti.
our organist colleague, I'm so glad he listened.
Great. I love it. You know, somebody you know. From Ernesto Matal Sol, Ernesto loves his clapping emojis, so 5 clapping emojis.
Okay, thank you.
And from Mary Kim, of course, who's performed here as well, that was gorgeous. And then from Sandy, no question, just wanted to say, beautiful performance, so lovely. And then love the composition. Are you kidding me? Gorgeous. And beautiful. So lovely to see a family of strings.
Oh, great. Thank you. Great. Thank you.
Wonderful. Always. And thank you so much for, I mean, you're our, you know, our anchor point, I think, in this concert. You and your family are. So really great. Thanks for joining us.
Anytime. It's a pleasure. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hopefully when this is all over, you can be our, you know, we can all perform in person. Well, you guys can perform in person for everybody.
Yes, we'll do it. Count on it.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Great.
Great.
Thank you.
Thank you so
Thank
much.
You. And then let me move the spotlight over to Shay. There we go. This is always the part that requires too much coordination from me. So Shay is also a repeat performer. Shay Luko is a MS5, medical student 5, for people who don't know the lingo. We'll be playing the piano, Stuck at Home But Not Alone, which is an original composition. She wrote this mm-hmm. piece to honor healthcare workers. She is a fifth year medical student currently completing a master's in biomedical informatics. He's been teaching himself, which is just amazing, to play piano for the last 12 years and enjoys jazz, blues, and contemporary improvisation. So where do you find the time?
Well, med school is very stressful, so I need to de-stress a lot. And piano definitely helps with that.
Absolutely. And any thoughts for mothers, nurses, or James Bond, in no particular order?
I definitely care about those three things very differently. So I would say for Mother's Day, I would just share a brief memory that is meaningful to me. I remember when my family moved to Memphis, Tennessee from Singapore, and kind of early on, I just remember this one memory where I like ran to my mom. She was sitting on the couch and I kind of just snuggled up in her lap, and I could kind of fit entirely there at the time. And I just, to me, that kind of embodies just the love of a mom and how unique and powerful and healing that can be. And I wish I could fit still, but I can't. And then my piece is, we'll have some words for those at the front line.
Great, we'll take it away.
Yep, and then just really quickly, I'm gonna use a looper when I play. So I'm going to play a loop first, and then I'm going to press something with my foot and it's going to loop that, and then I'll play over that. So you can just know that when there's background music, I'm going to play that right now first.
Thank you.
You're stuck at home, but you're not alone. No, we've got so much love right here for you. So let this music make your soul sway. Yeah, you don't have to worry, it'll be okay. It's been some months now that we've been cooped up. But those on the front lines have not given up. And I'm so grateful for all they've done. Yeah, and I'll keep praying until this battle's won. Thank you.
Fantastic. So, are you going to Beale Street, right, Memphis? That's your next stop.
after residency, maybe.
After residency. So many comments from your fellow performers. Genius to be a medical student and a self-taught musician and a singer who composed this song. From Jonathan Chen, is this the world premiere, Shane, of your song? Is this the first time?
Yes.
Okay, so from Jonathan, amazing world premiere. We all heard it here first.
Thank you so much.
Let's see here. Totally from Wizard Rick. Totally awesome loop track and all. Great voice of love.
Thank you.
Audrey, you're so talented, Shay. Thanks for sharing your creativity and beautiful music with us. The world of medicine is lucky to have you. From Anonymous, awesome groove and voice. And then from Jeanette Hung, this touches my heart. From Sandy, groovy, love it. I'm feeling chill already. Let's see here. From Donna Reen, thanks for this positive, upbeat song. It is sure to encourage and uplift a frontliner. Great. Fantastic. Well, thank you so much. Great. I'm going to hand it back to Jackie now, and give me 1 second to change the spotlight. So we'll go to Thomas next. I'm lost. This is the thing with Zoom. There you go. And Jackie will introduce Thomas.
There is Thomas. Thomas Schaefer is a software engineer living in Seattle with his wife, Stephanie, and guinea pig koala. And he is the son of who he calls the best mom, Dr. Audrey Schaefer, who this program would not exist if it wasn't for Dr. Audrey Schaefer. She started Medicine and the Muse, gosh, I think over 15 years ago in her living room. I'm sure Thomas was there involved in some of that. And I'm gonna maybe embarrass you a little bit, Thomas, because your mom said, "You're super sweet, caring, and loving, married to an amazing woman. You're an awesome brother to your sister, Rebecca, and I couldn't be a luckier mom," or mum, as we say in our family. So, wanted to share that, and Thomas is going to sing Amsterdam by Gregory Alan Isakov. And then if you want to answer Mother's Day nurses or James Bond.
You got to answer Mother's Day then, Jesus. Yeah.
Absolutely, yeah. So I guess I should start with James Bond, which I'm sure what everyone is curious to know. I think I've got to go with Daniel Craig on this one, just because he has such good like lip skills. He has very fine, like, sort of powdery lip. It's just incredible.
He's a super powder.
It's amazing. Yeah, I'm just so fortunate to have so many family members that are part of the medical staff and medical community. My mom, who is like such an inspiration to me, and I'm jealous of all the people that get to work with her, because that means they get to spend more time with her. Although I feel so fortunate to have that close family relationship, and wish that we could be with each other physically in for Mother's Day, but we have a Zoom brunch set up that I'm really looking forward to. Yeah, I have so many family members of my mom's sister is also in the medical profession, and my father-in-law, a cousin, medical profession, who's in medical school right now, and close family friends, my father and my stepmother, and it's really just so fortunate.
Well, that's wonderful, and I'm glad you could join us. So please take it away.
Thank you. I picked this song, one, because it's one that I knew or was working on, and two, it's a song about addiction, and I found in this time of sort of taking a pause, it allowed for me to think about, like, what were my routines and what was I constantly doing over and over again, and think about, like, are these healthy? Should I keep doing them? What are, like, the addictions that I have? And, you know, everybody has been touched by addiction in some way or another. That is why I picked the song, as I found it to be particularly relevant in self-reflection. All right, I have to take my headphones off. So here we go. The kites, that howling wind, everything, but she's easy on the eyes.
Fantastic. Wow, this is great. From Jackie, thoughtful choice of song. From Shay, love this. Takes me to a calm and peaceful place. Thank you. So heart from Moni, so heartfelt and sincere, Thomas. And it's wonderful finger picking from Esther. And then we have a bunch of other from the audience. From Leslie, yay, Thomas. We are always proud of you. Fabulous. from Anonymous, so awesome and heartwarming. From Sandy, beautiful and heartfelt, thank you. From Ernesto, congratulations. From Audrey, beautiful, Thomas, thank you. Wonderful to hear you play and sing. Sending love. And then from Jeanette Hung, so deep and soulful. From Ingrid, beautiful song. And then from Anonymous, whoa, I was blown away by your talent.
Wow, thank you so much. This was really fun.
Great. Well, yeah, really, thank you for joining us, and I hope you can perform for another concert.
Well, thank you.
And next up, we have Dr. Amy Alexander. If I can get my spotlight skills. There we go. So Dr. Amy Alexander will be on vocals with a backing track. She'll be singing On My Own from Les Mis. Dr. Alexander is a clinical assistant professor and director of the Student Mental Health Fellowship in the Department of Psychiatry and Behavioral Sciences. She's been singing since college and most recently was in a local production of the show Avenue Q. Great. Well, welcome.
And, hi, Bryant. Nice to meet you in person. I think
nice to meet
collaborated
you.
Collaborated before.
On Zoom. I know. Yeah, that's fantastic. I'm meeting all these new people. It's fantastic.
Yeah.
And you have such a lovely backdrop. You've got flowers, very colorful.
Kind of my virtual office right now.
And any response to the James Bond Nurses Week and Mother's Day question?
Yeah, absolutely. We could start with James Bond. You'll see my piece. So I love the singing actresses. So I love M, Judi Dench. She's just amazing. And then for nurses, absolutely big shout out, tribute, heart to you. We could not do what we're doing, especially in the hospital, without our wonderful nurses. And I actually invited a couple nurses to watch today, and we've been friends since residency, which was a long time ago. So yeah, really wonderful. And for mom, hi mom, I think mom is out there somewhere. Happy Mother's Day. And I didn't start singing till later in life. So my mom used to go around, she was naturally talented, and she would walk around the house singing. And probably that's where I got my love for singing. And also two other special Mother's Days to Mrs. Tevis, who turned 97 yesterday, happy birthday, and my Grandma Hill down in Southern California.
Fantastic. Well, please take it away. Love to hear your performance.
And everything, you're hearing the microphone? Yes. Yeah.
Yes, I hear the microphone.
Great. Okay.
We've become audio Zoom experts.
Yeah, in like a week.
Okay.
now I'm alone again, nowhere to turn, no one to go to. Without a home, without a friend, without a face to say hello to. And now the night is near, and I can make believe he's here. Sometimes I walk alone at night when everybody else is sleeping. I think of him, and then I'm happy with the company I keep in. The city goes to bed, and I can live inside my head. On my own, pretending he's beside me. All alone, I walk with him till morning. Without him, I feel his arms around me. And when I lose my way, I close my eyes, and he has found me. In the rain, the pavement shines like silver. All the lights are misty in the river. In the darkness, the trees are full of starlight, and all I see is him and me forever and forever. And I know it's only in my mind that I'm talking to myself and not to him. And although I know that he is blind, still I say, there's a way for us. I love him, but when the night is over, he is gone, the river's just a river. Without him, the world around me changes. The trees are filled everywhere, the streets are full of strangers. I love him, but every day I'm learning. All my life, I've only been pretending. Without me, this world would go on turning. A world that's full of happiness that I have never known. I love him. I love him. I love him. But only on my
fantastic. Amazing. Amazing. It, you know, it brought me back to when I was a kid, when I went to New York and saw Les Mis for the first time. So fantastic.
Yeah.
So many, many great comments. I'll start with your fellow panelists. Wetter from Shay, what a talented singer. From Mani, totally transported me into the musical Les Mis. Beautiful rendition.
Thank you. From Jonathan,
beautiful and dramatic. From Esther, good transitions from head and chest voice. Wow, that sounds very technical.
Yeah.
I don't even know what that means, but it sounds difficult. And from Amelia, I know, as a fellow singer, I know how difficult musicals can be. Just beautiful. Great tone, soprano voice. And of course, from the audience, from Kate, I am Amy's biggest groupie. Yes, bigger than Prince and Wellington. And her parents. So happy to get to see you perform again. You go, girl. All caps.
Thank you, Kate. Wow.
From Nassim. Wow. Just a wow. Dot dot dot. Let's see. Wonderful. From Jeanette. Beautiful. From Kay. Lovely performance. One of my favorite songs. Glad to see that you and your lungs have fully recovered. Smiley face emoji.
Thank you. Thank you.
from Anonymous, whoa, you could have been a professional singer. The medical profession is lucky it grabbed you instead. From Prince Alexander Stellar Eponine from Les Mis, bravo, Jean Valjean should know. And then let's see here, from Anonymous, wow, very talented. Thank you for sharing your beautiful voice and great choice of song. Great. Oh, let's see here. Trevor, you're beautiful in every way, from Grandma Hill.
Oh, great. Hi.
Beautiful in every way, including your voice, Grandma Hill.
Thank you. Very special.
Great. Well, thank you so much for joining us today. I hope you can join us again.
Thank you.
Great. Next, we will have Jackie will introduce Esther. There we go.
Oh, great. And your mom's there. Fabulous. Okay.
Don't hide. Don't hide, Mom.
I know. When we did the sound check, I said, are you guys sisters? I can't believe that's your mom. So this is Esther Zhu, and she is a junior at Lynbrook High School. She started piano in the first grade and flute in sixth grade. During her free time, she loves to draw, listen to Christian and classical music, and go hiking. Her mom, who she told me I could call her Q Ma, has worked at Stanford for 18 years and is the nurse coordinator for surgical urology oncology at the Stanford Cancer Center. And she was working today and wasn't sure if she'd get back in time. So I'm so glad you're with us. And both of you can answer the questions. Mother's Day, nurses.
Jackie, I just realized Q fulfills all three questions.
Oh, that's right.
Her name is Q, James Bond.
James Bond.
She's a nurse.
Yeah.
She's a mom. So there you go. Right. You got the triple crown there. You don't even have to ask the question. She just fulfills it.
That's right.
Yeah, I feel so fortunate to be able to work at my current department. We just had our monthly department meeting at 7 a.m. this morning, and we got a big shout out from our physician groups for Nurses Week. That was very nice. Yeah.
Oh, great. Great.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
We got a lot of comments from our patients, from our colleagues this week, throughout the week. So it's really nice. Yeah.
I think this time is absolutely renewed appreciation for nurses, for physicians. I mean, if that's a silver lining of all of this. Yeah, absolutely. Esther, would you mind saying the name of the piece that you're going to play and why you chose it?
I'm going to play Sonata in E flat major by Johann Sebastian Bach, and I chose it, I guess, because I have been practicing it, and it was one of the pieces that I was been practicing that fit the time limit.
Great reason. Perfect. Okay. Thank you for joining us. Go ahead and take it away.
Thank you.
That's great. You know, I have to tell you, I bought this Chinese bamboo flute, and I can't make it make a noise at all. So I appreciate how difficult it is. Really fantastic job from your fellow panelists. Beautiful playing from Jackie. From Mani says, terrific performance, very talented. From Amy, great job, Esther. I played flute growing up before singing, and you play very well, beautiful tone. From Thomas, incredible. Thank you so much for your performance. From the audience, so impressive, beautiful music. Thank you. From Anonymous. From Jeanette, so much talent. From Jill Coulson, so beautiful, Esther. From Sandy, so talented, beautiful. Wonderful. From Leslie, wonderful, thank you. Anonymous, really lovely, so glad to hear this live music, thank you. From Ernesto, wonderful performance. And from Calvert Lee, beautiful performance, thank you for sharing your talents with us. Great. Well, thank you. Well, I hope some of your classmates may be tuning in as well. Great. Well, I hope you can join us for a future concert. And thanks to Mom for sharing your daughter with us.
Thank you for giving her the opportunity.
Great. Oh, no problem. She's welcome to join us anytime. Perfect. So with that, we are going to go to Mani Farhadi. Mani Farhadi will be reading her poem, Stuck at Home, My Tribe and I. Mani is a senior facilities planner with Stanford School of Medicine, Office of Facilities, Planning and Management. Her background is in architecture. For 2 months, her college-age sons came home back home, and she wrote this poem to describe the scenario. Great. Well, thank you for joining us. And any comments about James Bond versus week and Mother's Day?
Certainly. Thank you so much, Bryant. James Bond, easy. Sean Connery. That's all I have to say. Nurses. My grandmother was a nurse. So I am Iranian-American background, and my grandmother was a nurse. Her name is Helen Jeffries from Idaho, and she married my Iranian grandfather, who was a doctor, and they met at a hospital. So our family has always, of course, treasured nurses and doctors. They ended up going to Iran afterwards, and my grandmother actually helped in the villages of Iran. They loved her so much in Iran, they actually named a mountain after her. So there is Mount Helen in Iran, and it's named after my grandmother. So would have to give her a shout out. As far as moms, definitely shout out to my mom in Chicago, the most incredible human ever. She's an author, philosopher, scholar, writer, editor, translator. The list is lengthy, and hopefully she'll be tuning in. My mother-in-law in Boston is like a second mom to me, so sending her lots of love. And my dad's wife, Shahla, wanted to thank her also for all the things she's done for me. So this poem for myself as a mom is definitely very meaningful. I did, as you mentioned, my sons came home for spring break. One is getting his master's at Juilliard, his first year, so he's in New York. And one is at UW in Seattle getting his degree in engineering physics. So they came home and all of a sudden they were sheltered in place, they were stuck. It sort of caused us to rethink everything, having the adults back home. And the thing was that it became actually a gift, a treasure of the time that we got to spend together. And my youngest did go back to Seattle. So right now we're down to one. And definitely feel their presence has enriched us. So just wanted to share that. And that's why I was inspired to write this story.
Great, thank you.
So I will share my screen as I read the poem to you. Our family was interviewed for Los Gatos Weekly on a story they were doing about college kids who come back home. So that's us on the cover, my son giving me a kiss because I cooked his favorite dinner. Here we go. Stuck at home, my tribe and I. Stuck at home, my tribe and I. Three men and a mom just getting by. What do we do to pass the time? Well, let me tell you a little rhyme. My sons came home for spring break with no plans, not thinking they'd stay long. Oh man, how quickly the virus has spread, turning into pandemic dread. Not used to living together, rediscovered being brothers. Setting boundaries, knock before you enter, a whole new dynamic to mentor. Stuck at home, my tribe and I, finding nooks and crannies to get by. Escaping to our rooms, we close the door when we can't take it anymore. We emerge for meals as a family four. Zoom classes and meetings are done for. We cook to eat, then hit repeat, round the kitchen table in stockinged feet. We sing and dance like in a trance, walk the hood of our stomping grounds. Rehearsing a short routine, even made a TikTok everyone seen. Stuck at home, my tribe and I, crisis keeps us indoors with a sigh. A world gone quickly upside down, having the boys here turns it around. Reliving the past, old albums to please, remembering them as babies, cleaning out the garage, old stuff we seize, holding on to those memories. Helping one with an audition self-tape, making background sound effects, helping the other do a workout, playing loud music without a doubt. Stuck at home, my tribe and I, watching old movies by the by, not knowing when it will end, using our time together, we mend. With all four of us online now, install new modem, what a row. Fighting for bandwidth, internet, upgraded boosters, we all set. Talking about relationships while snacking on potato chips. Life seemingly changed overnight, staying up late into the night. Stuck at home, my tribe and I, asking if they can leave, but why? The uncertainty of it all, wishing health and safety for you all. Thank you. That was my son in the background. I do want to say that I know some families don't have their children with them. One of mine just left. So a shout out to the families who aren't with their children or who aren't with their parents, thinking of them. And thank you for this opportunity.
Oh, thank you for sharing your experience and your sentiments with us. I got to ask you, why the audition tape in the bathroom? Is that because the acoustics are better or just because you have the shower bar?
The acoustics are better. We had a shower bar and it was a scene for Little Mermaid and we needed to have sound effects of water and a fan blowing and various things. So that's why we chose the bathroom.
That's great. Well, you have many comments from your fellow performers. Jackie said, loved hearing about your grandmother. From Amy Alexander, heartfelt, great choice of words. From Shay, really appreciate the unique combination of heartfelt pictures and words. Thanks for sharing. From Jonathan, great family story that resonates with all. From Amelia, thanks for sharing your creativity and great visuals. And from Thomas, beautiful and so heartfelt. And from the audience, many, many comments from Calvert Lee, very creative and poetic. Great to acknowledge the positive experience of a challenging time. Thank you. From Hale Hashemi.
It's my sister-in-law. My sis.
Loved it. Beautiful poem. Loved the reading and the photos. From Jeanette. With many W's. From Yi Pong. That was the best poem. From Jill Takazawa. Thank you for sharing your story with us.
Yeah, my colleague. Yeah.
Wonderful. Beautiful family. From Karen Thompson Hall. Loved Monty's story about her grandmother and Mount Helen. What a wonderful poem. It captured your family's experience so vividly. Thank you for sharing. And from Sandy, love that you made a TikTok.
Great we did. Helps to have the young generation at home.
What a wonderful family. Thank you for the poem. It was beautiful and so true. Great. Well, fantastic. Thank you so much for sharing.
Thank you.
Great. And then I'm going to hand it back to Jackie to introduce Dr. Terrigal Byrne.
Great, thank you. Dr. Byrne is a practicing general internist, formerly at Stanford and UCSF, and now at the Palo Alto Medical Foundation. And he is a jazz pianist. He'll be playing A Child is Born, composed by Dad. And I asked him the other day if his name was Scottish or Irish, and he said neither. It's actually Australian, I believe. Is that what you said, Terrigal?
That is indeed true, yeah. It's a little town near Sydney, Australia. I was born in Sydney, and my father liked the weird name.
Right. Oh, great. So do you have an answer to or a comment about either James Bond, Mother's Day, or Nurses Week?
Well, I like Eva Green, actually, in Casino Royale. I think she's the, but other than that, no, Mother's Day, well, they're kind of critical to all of our existence and a wonderful thing for us all to have. And nurses, well, I work with them all the time on their wonderful profession, and a pleasure to work with.
Fabulous. We're glad you're here. Go ahead and take it away.
Okay. Just a moment about this song. It's a jazz standard written by Fat Jones. He's a played trumpet and flugelhorn. He and his two brothers are well known within the jazz world. Elton Jones, who was the drummer that played with John Coltrane for many years, is his brother. And Hank Jones, who was a wonderful pianist, also is a brother of his. So he wrote this song in 1969, initially just as a instrumental, but Alec Wilder wrote some lyrics to it afterwards, which I can read if we are interested. And here we go. And I thought, since mothers have children, a child was born, did relate to Mother's Day.
Perfect. Thank you. Thank you.
Can you maybe not all the lyrics, but can you read us some of the lyrics?
Sure. Yeah. So that goes like this. Now out of
you the have song, to speak up a little bit because remember we tuned your mic for the piano. Yeah.
Okay. Here we go. Now out of the dawn, soft. No, excuse me. Now out of the night, soft as the dawn, into the light. This child, innocent child, soft as a fawn. This child is born. One small heart, one pair of eyes, one work of art. Here in my arms, here he lies, trusting and warm. Blessed this morn, the child is born.
Great. Well, fantastic. Many comments from your fellow performers. From Shay, a fellow jazz enthusiast. Wow, takes me back to the best jazz bar in Memphis. Enjoying a beautiful night and feeling right at home. Thank you. Also, where can we find more? There you go. So where can we find you performing?
Well, actually, I've been putting some videos out on YouTube and Facebook because of this, about one a week. I recently did a CD of solo piano. It's my third. I play over at Stanford at the hospital occasionally, but they have a lot of people coming through that big music series. And when there were some clubs around that one could play in, I was doing that some. So I'm happy to put people on my email distribution list if they want me to do that.
There you go, Shay. You have to get on his distribution list. And Chris Costanza said, I'll buy the house around, so we'll have to hold him to it. And then from from Amy, very nice, relaxing to listen to. From Esther, love how it's simple but still wonderful. From Moni, love this piece. It's calming and uplifting at the same time. From Thomas, so soothing and peaceful. From Jonathan, smooth and classy. And then from the audience, from Eli Zester, so awesome, you made my day. From Sandy, beautiful, so mellow and chill, thank you. From Yipong, so jazzy. From Leslie, thank you for your wonderful music. Great, fantastic. Well, thank you so much for joining us. I hope you can join us for future concerts.
That'd be fun. Thank you.
Great, thanks. And we will go next to something different. Let's see here. Ah, there's Jonathan. Yeah, we will spotlight him. Jonathan will be our first magician performing. You may recall Dr. Jonathan Chen from his earlier performance, but now he's going to be doing something a little bit different, magic. Creative money management techniques. Jonathan is an assistant professor in the Center for Biomedical Informatics Research and Division of Hospital Medicine. But his earliest career aspirations were to be a stand-up comedian. He hopes to share some smiles all the same. Perfect.
The musical bar in this club is just getting way too high. I was like, I gotta run. I'll try something different.
You know, what'll happen is you're going to inspire another magician to come on.
That'd be great. I've been trying to find some other people on campus. I don't know where they are.
They're all closet magicians. they're not closet musicians, but closet magicians. So Jackie will play your onstage audience member.
Very good. We can kind of go ahead and get started. This part isn't as sort of chat, but kind of thinking about all the different things we do, managing times of uncertainty. You know, of course, shout out to nurses who actually make the hospital and the clinics run. Shout out to my wife, who is a mom, Gino. She's also a physician scientist, works in the hospital, but also trying to keep our kids alive. Thanks to my own mom, who kind of advocated and supported us all our lives and also taught us some good lessons. You know, be smart and frugal with your money, especially in times of uncertainty. Just some tips that I've learned that I thought it'd be helpful for people to learn as well. Like, for example, what do we have here? Jackie, I just got some dollar bills is all it is. I got five $1 bills. And so you might not think much about that. I mean, you can't even buy a cheeseburger value meal with this nowadays. But the thing is, don't just dismiss it, especially in these times. You got to keep it. You got to save it, right? Big things come from small things. Keep your small bills, save them, invest them, and you could turn this into something more. Like, literally, you might just be able to just turn that into something more. Got a little bit more to work with. Like,
very good.
There you go. 100x multiplier.
That's awesome.
So you're buying the second round.
It's pretty exciting, right? Take that NIH grant committee. I don't need your stinking money. but you know, I got to work out a backup plan in case things don't work out. But before we get too excited, I mean, this is pretty exciting, right? But if I could actually just make $100 a pill or out of nowhere, do you think I'd work the crazy job that I do? Actually, I probably would. I mostly do what I do for fun. But the problem is, this looks pretty real. If we were here in person, you could touch this. You could feel this. This feels very real. But the problem is, if you watch closely, you'll realize it was all just...
Oh, wow.
That's great.
$100. Okay. Back to work for me. Okay. But all right, so we can't actually make money. That was all just illusion. We got to find some other strategies. Shaq, you can help me out. Maybe we can gamble some money. We're going to gamble for real, just for fun. I don't know if you've ever seen like the three-card Monty game they play on Street. Like, here's the money card. If you pick this card, you win 20 bucks. If you pick the Joker, you pick wrong, then you owe me 20 bucks. Right, this is just, we're just playing this for fun. We're not actually doing this for money, just for example. But Jackie, just for example, can you tell me, where's the money card, the queen? Is it in my hand or is it on the table right now?
I think it's on the table.
You might think it's on the table.
Oh, shoot.
In my hand, right? Because in the moment where I'm talking about this nonsense about what the mic, I'm just trying to distract you. Don't pay attention to what I'm saying. I'm totally just trying to distract you in that moment. I'm swapping the cards out. Now that you get how the game works, though, we're going to slow it down. I need to make this a little bit trickier, though, because you guys know what's going to happen. You can follow me. So I'm going to add the second joker here. So remember, just follow the money card, which is the queen. Don't get distracted by the joker, because that's the only thing that you have to look out for. As now think about, Jackie, where's the queen right now?
On the table.
Right, so on the table, it seems like it's there, but again, you gotta watch closely, otherwise you miss the moment it gets swapped, right? Okay, we'll simplify, okay? Let me just do two cards, maybe three cards is a little bit too much, because I know it gets a little bit disorienting, okay? All right, let's practice one more time. Jackie, where's the queen right now?
It's facing down in your hand.
Right, it kind of seems like it might have been there, except if we're watching, I mean, let me simplify. I don't know, it might be confusing. I'll put this one away for a second. And for reals, I really do have just two cards here. If you were here in person, we could do this. This is the Joker and the other Joker, right?
Yes.
Bryant, are you paying attention? Where's the phone right now, Bryant?
In your pocket.
My pocket? Why would you say that?
That's great.
I thought you guys were going to pay attention. Well, okay. I'll level with you. Here's another lesson. Do not ever play this game for money, all right? This is not a game. This is a scam, right? Because the thing is, you would probably bet $100 the queen is on the table right now, right? Except that if you take a look, you'll find that there is no queen anywhere.
Oh my God.
Because the guy has already put it back in his pocket, so you never even have a chance to pick the winning card. Okay, we're going to slow this down. Slow down, right? I'm not so simple. What card is on the table right now?
Brian, I'm going to let you answer.
No, you do it.
It's the queen.
You're onto it. Exactly. It is the queen. Very good. You got it. And you know why it is? Because look at this. I would never scam you in these times of uncertainty. Let's stick together and I'll make sure you get that winning card every single time.
Oh my God. That was great.
That's great. We're going to have
to have
you more.
That was good.
You've got the good shtick too. I think that's what one of the comments was is, Audrey, well done. So entertaining. Great patter too. Love this magic. From Suzanne Tamang, wow, with two capital W's. So from Eliza, they're so awesome. It made me so happy. You made my day. Great. And then from Mani Farhadi, forget your PhD. You need to do magic for a living. Amazing. Great sense of humor. Wish I could clap out loud and not be muted. You can unmute yourself, Mani. From Thomas, phenomenal.
Yay!
From Shay, this is so amazing and hilarious. Not sure if Dr. Chen's magic or his career as a computer science PhD and internist is more impressive. Amazing talent, personality, and super entertaining. Amy Alexander, tricky. Money, very nice. from Esther. Wow, with many W's. That was great. From Calvert Lee, so entertaining and gave us lots of laughs. Thank you. From Anonymous, I demand more magic. from Sandy, what? I'm stumped. Love it. From Yipong, wow, with many smiley emojis. Great. And then from Anonymous, so wonderful. This put a big smile on my face. What a talent. Great. Thanks, well, thank you for sharing that. I really hope you can come back. I want to see that in person.
When we start doing this live, I'm ready to do this. Is meant to be in person. I'm meant to put the card, the money right in your hand, and it's even more fun. But I don't know when that'll be socially acceptable for a while. So we'll do it.
Great. Well, thank you so much, Jonathan.
Thanks, Jonathan.
And last but not least, a fan favorite, especially with her rendition of Happy Birthday to her own mother last time. It's Amelia Liggins, and Jackie will be introducing her.
Yeah, so I met Amelia at an open mic night, and I was so impressed. I invited her to come to sing for one of my classes of physicians, and they all were just amazed by her. So I'm so happy you're able to join us. Amelia will be singing Shine on Us by Phillips, Craig, and Dean. Amelia is a senior talent acquisition consultant and recruits healthcare technology professionals for Stanford Healthcare. She's a gospel singer, church worship leader, and wedding singer. She loves gospel because it allows her to express her love for God while singing from her soul. And so if you have an answer to the three questions, we know your mom's watching for Mother's Day, James Bond, and nurses.
Yes, well, I'll start with Mother's Day. First of all, happy Mother's Day to my own mother and all of the wonderful mothers out there. I know that without our mothers, you know, many of us wouldn't be where we are today. I appreciate the sacrifice my mother made for me and my sister. She was a mother of a single mother of four and did an awesome job. So thank you, mother. And to my sisters who are mothers, and again, all of the women out there who are raising children and have raised children. And certainly thank you to all of the nurses. I know it's Nurses Week. Without them, you know, what would we do? Thank you to the nurses for your sacrifice and being on the front line. The James Bond movie, great action movie. That's all I can say about that.
All right. Well, I'm so happy we can close with this beautiful song. Thanks, Amelia.
Yes.
Take it away.
And I'll say a quick thing about the song. It's called Shine on Us. And essentially, it's a prayer. And it's asking God to shine his light, shine his grace, and shine his love on us, all of us, especially during this time.
Light from your face, shine on us. Lord, let your light from your face, shine on us. That we may be saved. That we may have light to find our way in the darkest night. Let your light shine on us. Lord, let your grace raise from your hand, shine on us. Lord, let your grace from your hand, shine on us. That shine on us. And Lord, let your love, love with no wind, shine on us. Lord, let your love, love with no wind, shine on us, that we may be saved, that we may have light to find our way in the darkest night. Let your light shine on. Let your light shine on. Lord, let your love shine on
us. Really amazing. You just like never cease to amaze me. Your voice, incredibly, not an easy song to sing either. So the fantastic. Many comments from your fellow performers, from Jackie. Amelia, you're beautiful inside and out. From Amy, Amelia, so heartfelt and gorgeous singing. From Esther, wonderful deep vibrato. From Jonathan, a powerful. And from Shay, could not have ended this in a more beautiful and powerful way. Thank you for bringing us this blessing, Amelia. From Moni, such a moving performance, Amelia. So full of love. Thank you for sharing your gift. From Thomas, truly amazing. So from the audience, wow, what a gift. Thank you. From Leslie. From Audrey, gave me shivers, so gorgeous and soul-stirring. From Lisa, thank you for sharing your prayer of hope. It was an encouragement to me. Did you write it?
I did not write it. No, I won't take credit for that one.
From Kedar Nandan, what a vocal reach. From Anonymous, that was great. From Sandy, amazing and beautiful. From Jeanette, so powerful and passionate. And from Calvert Lee, beautiful voice, beautiful and moving. From Eli Zester, who I just found out is my kids in the other room making comments online under a fake name, they said, OMG, so good. Great. Well, thank you so much. I hope, again, you can join us for a third concert.
Would love to.
Great.
Thanks for having me.
Fantastic. Well, with that, we have ended our seventh fantastic virtual concert. Really thanks to all of you for joining us. Happy Nurses Week. Really thanks to all the incredible work the nurses do. We cannot, healthcare could not function without the nurses. Great thanks to Jackie, who's my host, who is a mother and a grandmother. Jackie, is your grandson watching today?
You know, he's been watching the next day because this is his bedtime. So it's tough since he's on the East Coast.
Well, I hope he wishes you, I hope he has something special in plan for you for Mother's Day. Again, special thanks to my own mother, hopefully, watching from Tennessee, and my wife who's finishing making the paella I started just before hopefully it's not burnt, just before the concert started. So thanks, be safe, have a great week.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Jacqueline Bryant. Nice to meet everyone.
Thank you.
Bye.
Hi.
Thank you all.